Hello there, welcome once again at the Royal Belgian Institute for Natural Sciences. I am Koen Stein, I'm a paleontologist, and today we have an exclusive look within the cage of the Bernissard iguanodons. Now, I'd like to focus in this little clip on the hand of the iguanodon, and one of the most prominent features on the hand of iguanodon, I have a little aid to show you better, one of the most prominent features is the thumb spike. And when these animals were first discovered, they didn't have complete skeletons, and they thought that this thumb spike was actually supposed to be put on the nose of the animals, much like rhinoceros iguanas that we have today. But because of the findings that of these iguanodons in Bernissard, we know that it's actually part of the hand. And in life, this thumb spike would have been covered by a keratinous sheath, making it much bigger. And keratin, it's the same material that you find in your fingernails or in your hair. So it's a material that typically wouldn't fossilize with the rest of these skeletons. The function of the thumb spike, it's still hotly debated. There's no consensus, but potentially it could have served as predator deterrence, so fighting off potential attackers, or for fighting amongst individuals over resources like female or food. So we still don't know for sure what this thumb spike was used for. Now, on the other side of the hand, down here, we have the pinky finger. And the pinky finger, it's much more flexible. It has many more joints, and it was probably prehensile. So the animal could probably grasp onto things and manipulate foodstuffs and whatnot. So we have two, it's almost like a Swiss pocket knife, having these multifunctional digits. And in the center of the hand, we have three fingers that served while they were walking on all fours. So in another video clip, we explain why these animals were probably not in this biped position as they are now, but rather walking on four legs. And this is one of the features how we know why these digits are typically adaptations for walking and not for grasping or clawing.